Good morning.
Hello.
So, new doctor arriving today?
So?
Worried?
Why?
Female, apparently.
It was a 50-50 chance.
She might be very good.
Let's hope so.
She might be stunningly attractive. She could be tall, incredibly tall, willowy. She may be intelligent, but humble. Men, women, and small children will fall in love with her instantly. She might be Latin. Olive skin, husky voice.
That'll be nice for everyone.
You put all these elements together, what have we got? We've got potentially, today in this hospital, a very tall, genius, woman of the people, uber babe, Latino chick coming to work here.
Will she be too tall to get through the doors?
Oh, no, no. She'll be the perfect height.
Good. Well, that's all tickety-boo by me.
No. Not even the tiniest bit?
No, because jealousy is an ugly emotion and only for the weak.
OK, what I want you to do for me, just once, try it, pretend.
Why? Because it turns you on?
Yeah. Please. For me.
If you see the new bitch, snap off her fingers, burn her hair and pluck out her nipples.
OK.
Yes. And how do you feel? How do you feel?
Yes.
Dangerous? Liberating? Yeah? Orgasmic?
Exhilarating. Oh. In a dirty sort of way.
Have you seen them?
What?
The juniors, the students, Martin, Boyce, all of them.
Yeah, what about them?
Well, a new woman turns up, right? A frankly, pretty ordinary woman, and they're all like bees around a honeypot.
No. No, bees make honey, don't they?
Yeah, so?
Yeah, so? So why are bees bothering with a pot of honey? Yeah? Why not stay back at the hive where there's as much honey as they could have, yeah? Yeah? Why flap all the way down to the supermarket or somebody else's house or wherever this honeypot is? When there's plenty of honey at home.
Yeah, well, all right, well, flies are in a honeypot, then.
No, flies prefer shit.
Well, wasps, the fact is, it makes men look like a sad, desperate species.
Right, so, well, you probably think that it would be better if everybody was a little bit more like you.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, well, no, because then, of course, there would be a great surge in lesbianism.
Bet you can't headbutt that sign. Yeah, well, that was actually quite an easy one.
Nice.
I'm sorry to intrude. I know you're busy, but this is Henry's new surgical registrar, Caroline Todd. This is Dr. McCartney.
Hi, Mac. Call me Mac. Hi.
Hi. Any relation to...
Ringo Starr? No, actually, but impeccable timing, cos we're a pair of hands down on a routine hernia operation.
Whoa! They haven't actually had a pager yet.
Well, then that's good, because she won't be paged halfway through the operation.
What about her ID tags? Thought about that?
Yep, I can vouch for her ID. You definitely look like a doctor. Yep, dilated pupils, no sense of humour, and, you smell, is that minicabs? Hey, come on. Okay, let's go. Come on.
I am starving. They never give you decent portions here.
No, they do. You just have to be nice. If you flatter them, you'll have more food on your plate than you can ever deal with. It's very simple.
Yeah, how do you flatter a woman like that? Nice overall. Ooh, what an alluring scent of fat. I've always admired career women such as yourself.
Yeah, that'd do, yeah.
Can I get you, love?
Hello. Well, oh, crikey. The chili looks fantastic, as ever. Cilicetan kidney pipe also looks tremendous. You're spoiling us today, as ever.
I can do you a bit of both if
could
you want.
Could you? That would be brilliant. Thank you.
Chips and peas?
Yes, please. Brilliant. These are the best chips in the whole country. Superb chips. Always nice to have a little bit of glamour while you're dining. So,
there you go.
Great. Thank you very much. Thank you. You have a fantastic day now.
I will. Same to you, my love. Ta-da.
A blouse?
What?
It's a blouse, isn't it?
Fuck off. It's designer.
What, Laura Ashley? Are those roses?
No. Well?
Blouse.
Fuck. You are a jongeur.
I am a fraise blonde.
Oh, God. What a night.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I'm just a bit stiff. A few aching, probably a little bit of a groin strain.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, and aching tongue.
kind of my staff working with aching tongues.
Your staff?
Yeah, my staff. I am the surgeon. You are my anaesthetist.
I'm not your anaesthetist. You're my surgeon. You're my surgeon bitch.
No, you create the environment in which I can do my job.
Cut it open, bitch.
Gas her, fucker.
Sew it up, gimp.
You are essentially part of my team.
What? I'm not part of your team.
You are part of my fucking team.
What the fuck are you talking about? I'm not part of your team.
You are part of my team.
You're part of my anus.
You are like the unprofessional co-pilot that causes a massive aeroplane disaster because he has no real sense of his true position. How you owe me respect by being part of my team. I am the captain. You are effectively the first officer.
No, I'm the captain. You're the trolley dolly.
I bet you I'm the captain.
Bet you I am.
I bet you I am.
Bet you I am.
Bet you
I am.
Bet you don't even know where the cockpit is.
All right, here we go. Let's make it fair. Whoever gets the newest member of the surgical team to spend the night at their place first gets to be captain.
Why?
You're too late. I win.
Why?
You're the baby. I'm the placenta.
Sorry. Could I get some more nuts?
Yeah.
Please?
Yeah. Well, you can't use mine because they're all.
I'm trying to fly.
They're
my
squeezed
plane.
Out. They're juiced out. You know what I'm saying?
My plane. You go and clean the toilet.
They've been.
Yeah?
Can I have a quick word?
Zoom and whoosh. There you are. Quick words. Words that are quick.
Oh, I get it.
Got it?
Yeah, very, very good.
Yes, go on. Promise not to confuse you this time.
Okay. Yeah. I just want to say that despite signing confessions and so on, some people still have slightly the wrong idea. So just to clarify. I did stay, guys, but nothing happened. I was going to book into a hotel.
Can I stop you there?
So if anybody mentions it, I'd be grateful if you'd put them straight.
Yeah, nothing to do with me.
No, if anybody does mention it.
Why do you think I'm interested?
No, I never said you'd be interested.
So why bore me with all the details?
Don't be so bloody rude. Yeah,
I have a job to do. I'm not interested in your personal life. If that offends you, if it bothers you, then I apologise. Staff at your previous hospital might have found you totally fascinating. I don't.
If anything, that's an increase in the rudeness.
Ooh, I hope nobody starts gossiping about me, because I'd hate to be the centre of attention.
That is not fair.
I don't care. You know, I'm not bothered. I'm sick of hearing about you and Guy on your night of passion or non-passion.
So people have been talking.
They're talking and not concentrating on their jobs. Do your job, Dr. Todd. Keep your personal life personal. Allow my staff to concentrate on their work. I think there's enough soap opera set in hospitals, don't you think? What? I don't need this.
You're the drama queen.
No, the point about public school is that it's character forming.
Yes, indeed. Well, it certainly did form you into a rude, arrogant, selfish bastard with no interest in anybody but yourself.
Thanks.
It's okay.
Yeah, but it also means that I know that selfish and no interest in anyone but yourself mean the same thing.
Yes, yes, but so does fuck off and...
Piss off.
No, you piss off.
No, you piss off.
Oh, Dr. McCartney, Dr. Mac. Can I ask you a professional opinion?
Yes, it's definitely a chest.
Yeah, I know that.
Good. Be a bit of a worry if you didn't know that. So, should we have another look? I would say it's the chest of maybe a 10, 11-year-old boy.
Fuck off! It's my chest.
Really? Can you see why I thought it might have been a boy's?
No, I can't. I was just wondering if if you could see anything wrong.
No, it looks pretty clear. Of course, you shouldn't really be using hospital equipment for your own diagnosis unless you are ill, and even then you should really be consulting another doctor.
Well, I'm consulting you, aren't I? I also have a very very sore throat. Do you think it could be cancer of the esophagus?
No, I don't think it is.
Well, you haven't even examined me. Don't you want to check my throat to be sure?
Yeah. OK, fine, go on, open up. Yeah, see? Mm. Is it ah?
Ah.
Is it ah?
Ah.
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 Ah. Ah. Ah. Ah. Ah. Ah. You're a bastard.
You are completely fine. You are completely fine. You know what you want to do? Maybe think about investing in some mouthwash. Probably not.
Really?
No. Gonna go for a spin. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, do you want a ride?
Isn't that a health hazard? And you wonder why they won't make you a consultant.